Hello, good morning everybody. In this video, we will add a crossbow to our weapon repertory. Without further delay, let's begin. First of all, we need two images, one for the crossbow and the other for his arrow. I already have them. I downloaded the images from spritecatalog.com, link in the description. Let's start with the arrow. We called create a new scene. But why start from scratch when we already have a scene that does almost exactly what we want? I'm talking about the Goblin's Throwable Knife scene. Rename the scene and the script to Projectile. Both projectiles will inherit from this scene. I move them to the weapons folder, but you can use the folder you want. Also, it's very important that you mark as true the local to send option of the shape. Otherwise, the two projectiles, the knife and the arrow, will share the same shape. And we don't want that. They have different sizes. I spend too much time trying to figure out why the shape size changed automatically. Actually, the projectile can collide only with the player and the walls. Let's make it collide with anything. Enemies and other projectiles too. Open the script and set the corresponding collision mask bits at the body entered function below the order 2. So now, when the projectile exits the body of the character who threw it, all these collisions are activated. Now, we don't have the knife scene the goblin is expecting, so if you play the game, it will crash. Just create a new inherited scene from the projectile scene, change his name to Throwable Knife, and save it to the location where the first knife scene was. Actually, I had a typo. I wrote knife instead of knife. After that, create the arrow scene. Like the knife, inherit from the projectile scene. Change the knife sprite for the arrow one, readjust the shape, and set the initial collision mask to player. Remember that the collision mask will change after exiting a body, in this case the player, because we changed it to the player layer. This way, we avoid damaging the same character who launches the projectile. The arrow is ready. It's time to create the crossbow weapon. Create a new inherited scene from the weapons scene. Change his name to crossbow and save it. Load the crossbow image into the sprite. Move it a bit to the right if you want to separate it a little from the player. And create the player detector's collision shape. We could create two classes of weapons. One for the melee weapons and one for the ranged ones. But Godot does not allow to set a scene inheritance. So instead, we will make a few modifications to the weapons script. Inside the script, add two export variables. A boolean with the name ranged weapon that stores whether the weapon is ranged or not. Initialize it to false. And an integer with the name rotation offset that stores the offset degrees of the weapon. Initialize it to 0. We will use this variable to adjust the rotation to make the crossbow face the right direction. Next, scroll down until you find the move function and add an if to check if the weapon is ranged. If so, set the rotation degrees to the angle of the mouse plus the rotation offset of the variable we just created. The angle function returns the angle in radians. To convert it to degrees, I use the radians to degrees function. If the weapon is not ranged, execute the code we already had in the function. To summarize it, if the weapon is ranged, we will only rotate it. We won't flip it, change the knockback direction, or block it after attacking. Now, create a new script for the crossbow. Don't forget to extend the weapon class. At the beginning, add a constant that stores the arrow scene. To shoot the arrow, create a function called shoot, with an offset integer parameter. The offset has a default value of 0. We will use it later for the charged attack to shoot 3 arrows. Inside the function, create a new instance of the arrow scene. Spawn it as a child of the current scene, and call his launch function. The first argument is the position. The global position in this case, since we want the absolute position. The second parameter is the direction. We can calculate it by rotating a left vector with the rotation degrees of the crossbow plus the offset. I use a left vector because the crossbow is facing the left by default. The rotated function expects the angle in radians. That's why we have to use the degree to radians function. The last parameter is the speed. Let's put 400. Below, create a function for the charged attack called triple shoot. We will simultaneously shoot 3 arrows. Call the shoot function 3 times, with 0 offset, with 12 degrees of offset, and with minus 12 degrees of offset. Open back the crossbow scene. Set the ranged weapon exported variable to true, and set the rotation offset to 180 to make it face the right direction. You can try to use it without changing the offset. The result will be a crossbow that faces the contrary direction. Finally, modify the animations. Remove all the tracks that change the rotation or enable or disable the hitbox. We won't need them for the crossbow. Also, you probably want to reduce the animation length to increase the attack speed. Otherwise, it will have to wait more than 1 second to recharge. To call the functions we have in the script, we have to add a new method tracked for it. Then, with right click, insert key, we can add a call to the function. In the attack animation, we call the shoot function to shoot a single arrow. In the strong attack animation, we call the triple shoot function to shoot 3 arrows. With that, we have a fully functional crossbow. We can shoot 1 arrow with the normal attack, and 3 with the charged attack. If you watched the active ability tutorial and want to add an active ability for the crossbow, we can do it easily. Just add an icon to the under texture of the ability icon node and create an animation called active ability that will be executed when we activate the ability. If you play the game again, you will be able to unleash the active ability. And that's all for today. I hope you liked the video, and see you in the next one.